Hi, Master. You've
Hi.
actually already answered my question, the first question, which was the golden recipe for how to maximize our.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, told you. Huh? Get a mountain with the sea in front of it. Hold on to the two trees and breathe and see the sun. And at night, go out, see the moon, the stars. Yes?
With Master sitting beside
Yeah,
us.
Master sitting next to you. Hold hands. Yes? You wish, huh? So many disciples, I will have trouble holding hands. No wonder Quan Âm Bodhisattva have 1,000 hands, but then not enough still. 1,000 is nothing. 1,000 hands, 1,000 eyes is nothing, right?
Hi, Master.
Hi.
I'm so glad to see you here.
I'm sure you are.
Master, I have two questions. The first one is, it seems like before the sun did not give us as much blessing as it does now.
The sun?
Yes.
Oh.
Did you and heaven work out some sort of agreement where the sun can give us more blessing?
No, it's the same, honey. Why? Did I say before the sun bless you less? You feel less before?
No. I'm just curious.
Okay, no.
Yes.
If you feel less blessing before, it was because you're on the lower level,
Yes.
not connected too well, you see, with the natural universal energy of blessing. See, the more you practice, the more sensitive you become to this higher vibration. Before we're on lower vibration, see, we're more covered and more coarse. So just receive the coarse energy. The higher you go, the more fine, refined energy.
Yes.
And you feel more blessing of more. Elated because you're higher, okay? Not because the sun changed. Sun has not changed. Nothing has changed. We have changed.
I got it. Thank you, Master.
Yes.
And the second one is, how much spiritual point are needed to extend SBL?
Extend. Oh, that depends on which SBL. Depends on where, and how big and how broken it was, or how thin it is. Okay? Yes. So there's no fixed definition. Yeah? The thicker it becomes, the longer it becomes, the better. The more connected the two end, the better. Huh? Okay.
Thank you, Master.
You're welcome.
Hi, Master. I think you've already answered this one too about the karmic structure with how you fixed it for peace in the world. The question was if there was anything we could do to help.
You are helping by being good, by being selfless, by being dedicated to the cause of the planet or the cause of the world, and by being good yourself. You create a peaceful atmosphere, at least to some extent, you see? And if all people are like this, then peace will last forever. Peace will be immediately. It's just longer because even though I fix, for example, or any master fix, it takes longer because the atmosphere keep polluting it. See what I mean? We want peace, but we do violence. See what I mean? We want life, but we keep killing men and animals. So heaven have different signals. Say, oh, my children want war. You see what I mean? If we keep killing animals, that is signal of violence, signal of war. You see? We are the children of heaven. Heaven wants what we want. Even bad or good, we have the free will. We're the children of God. We're the master of the universe. Whatever we want shall be done. If we want war, there shall be war. So if we want peace, the planet has to rise up as the whole humanity. We have to show the sign of peace. We have to show the action that we want peace. You see, you can't go north and expect to be in south. You can't keep killing animals and say, I want peace, because killing is war. You see what I mean? Even it's just one-sided war. And we war against the animals. The animal never war against us, not even defense. You know, war normally is both sides, you see? Oh, well, sometimes one side also, if the country is stronger, just overwhelm the other country. make war. And here we make constant war every day with billions of animals. And we expect peace? How? Heaven reads our signals. All the deities obey our command. If we want peace, we have to signal peace, okay? Have to do it to show that we really want peace, that we're peaceful, we love peace. See, we can't just want peace and go on doing this war stuff, even with animals. Got what I mean? Like attract like, huh? All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome, love. You're welcome. It's just that just some peace is better than nothing, okay? Yes. To have complete peace still take a little effort from everybody. That's why I ask everybody, please help by being good, by being vegan, as a sign of peace. For heaven to know that we truly want peace, that's the way we want our life, you see? The lifestyle we want. Then peace will come without signing, without arguing, without anything, no condition. Signal is what heaven needs from us, not prayers. Prayers, just talk.
Yeah.
Master, you said something in the video conference in Dubai that I really don't understand. You said something like, you give your points away to create peace on earth, and that I understand, but you said, in case I give everything, I tell you honestly, I will not be able to go to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand that.
Why not?
How can someone as
why not?
Selfless and divine as you not go to heaven?
How can Jesus die on the cross when he only does good things? If you give all your money away, won't you become poor? Even if you're a billionaire, you give all your money away, what would you have? Zero. And you'll be homeless. No?
Yes.
Same? Same. If, in case I have to give everything away, try to save some, but in case if I have to, I will do that. It's lucky that I don't go to hell already. Not to talk about not go to heaven.
Is there anything we can do to help you complete?
You are helping already. It's not much about in your hands. Not everything in our hands. See? It's the whole human consciousness. We want to make heaven on earth. It's not that easy because we don't have cooperation of everybody. The government just stuck there. I go every time, a meeting, wherever I can. Yeah? Always talk about money, planning to get money in order to give money or to take money from in order to mitigate climate change. But the one thing easy to mitigate now, just to stop animal products. Nobody talk about that. Really. President mentioned a little, and somebody mentioned a little bit only, but not for discussion, just mention it. But not say, okay, are we going to do this or not? You do the vegan stuff or not? They're not like that. Not up to now, I don't hear. I could have missed one or two meetings because of other engagement. But wherever I can attend, I don't hear that. Every country just beg for more money. You know, the underdeveloped or developing country beg for more money. And the developing country plan to get money from the carbon emitting producers, you know, like taxing how much for carbon. It doesn't help the planet if you tax more, because some people can afford it. See what I mean? Some rich country, rich company, they don't care how much they pay. You see what I mean? It's nothing to them. Meanwhile, we still suffer from climate heating up and upheavals and storms and, you know, earthquake and everything else, you name it. And people are still hungry, you know, dying. Children still have no medical care, no food, no water even. Understand? I don't know how much money can we fix the water shortage in Saudi Arabia or in other country, you know? For example, I don't know how much money we can buy the water. If we don't have, we don't have. Huh? And you have a big diamond like this, you walk around in the desert, selling to whom? Huh? To the sand dunes? Yeah, you die with a diamond in your hand. Useless. How come nobody see this? It's so difficult. Just take care of yourself, okay? After we've done our best already, there's a limit time we do things. And then we just go back, retreat. I mean, retreat into your own home, your center, whatever, meditate. Profit the time that God gives you on earth. Profit the sun, the moon, the star, the wind, the air, wherever you live. Profit whatever you have there, okay? And go to high heaven. You know what? Even if I give everything and everybody goes to heaven, I'm alone here, so what? I'm only one, you know? Nobody bugs me anymore. I don't need to give anything anymore. I don't have to go anywhere. I'm okay alone on the planet. I don't care.
Master, we were actually hoping that you might share some new and important information with us. And we were wondering, is there anything that we didn't ask that we should have asked? Is there anything that you'd like to share with us?
Maybe next time. Don't worry. You know, you need time to digest things. You can't just eat everything at once. Besides the timing, you know, if I give you so much food, you can only eat so much. Slowly.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Master.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Wasn't that not new enough for you, all this thing? Or they are not new?
That was lots of information. We're just greedy, you know. I mean, what can I say? We're not perfect yet.
No, it's fine. Of course, of course. But the thing is, practice what you know, okay?
Okay.
Not just knowing and just for curiosity. Mm? They are precious info, okay?
Yes.
It takes also my time and research to do it, and my love put into it.
Yes, yes, Master.
Also, it depends on the time, you know? Like your children, when they grow up, how big, then you give them what, you know? Okay? Yes. All right.
So?
Huh?
I just want to thank you.
Yeah, okay. But it's good up to now that even though I don't tell you that much, I just tell you be compassionate. And then you just listen to me and you became vegan and you do help others from all of your heart. That is even better than when you know why you should do it. You see what I mean? That was very good of you. So all of this time, and now you earn this information. All right?
Yes.
Maybe you do something more, who knows, and then you earn more information. Yeah? Or maybe that's enough already. Yeah, what else you want to know what for? Huh? You have everything, sun, moon, star, huh? And you have your so-called master, huh? Hmm. And you have each other. Oh, you know what? It's a pity. You can bless each other and you can bless other human beings, but most other human beings cannot bless each other. I'm so sad. Animals can bless us. We can't even bless each other. And we have potential. But the vast power of the universe within us, we're God children, and God dwells within us. And if we don't practice spiritual, can't even bless anybody. Isn't that a sad thing? Have money and don't use for yourself and for your relatives, your friends, your country? Nada. It's the same. You have a lot of money in the bank and you just don't use it, even for yourself. And you live every day like a poor person, beggar even. Understand me? Same. The unspiritual person have the vast potential blessing power within him or herself, untouched. Even pray, heaven don't listen. You see what I mean? Because they don't pray with the whole heart, they just pray. You know, because it's a ritual, tradition, but they don't really pray with their heart. Sometimes people are sincere, even outside people, you saw it. They pray sincerely for their relative or the sick person. Miracle did happen because at that time they were really sincere. And they rise themselves up to meet heaven at that time. You see what I mean? The connection is there, flak a little bit. Just like electricity sometimes, it's kaput, but put in a bit, boop, a little bit, and then kaput again, because it's kaput. But it's a flash a little while, you see what I mean? Yeah, like that. But the people who practice, like one practitioner, for example, the power is always on standby.
Can I ask one about spiritual blessing lines?
Sure, sure.
You actually said that it would be a good idea if we sat on them, but I don't know. I don't know where they are. Does Canada have any?
Yeah, I told you we have some, but not always nearby you or not where you expect it to be, see?
Yeah.
Wherever. Concerning us, I already told you guys. Here in Cancun, we have three.
Yes, yes.
I told you?
Yes.
Cancun is so small, have three spiritual blessing lines. No wonder people all come here and feel happy, you know?
Wow.
Yes. Just like Monaco is so small. Everybody happy because for small size, there are a lot of spiritual blessing lines. That people all go there and like it, happy. See what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Here in Cancun, there's one hotel that one spiritual blessing line go through it. Only in one room. No, because it goes through that room. Only because I went here before you came and I stayed in that hotel, so I knew it. Otherwise, I also did not know. It's called Omni Hotel. On the 9th level. I forgot the room. Ha! Of course, I don't remember the room. I could check it out, but why? My God. And you all go there? Okay, you have a lot already. You have Master Power Blessing, which is more than any spiritual blessing line can combine.
Yes.
You have more than the sun, and you have the sun, you have the moon, you have the star. You know everything now. Just make use of it. Every time you meditate, every time you remember, just thank you. Please bless me. Thanks for your blessing. And take it in. Okay? Ah, thank you, all of you. All of you, all the trees, the plants, the earth, the air, the sun, the moon, the stars, all the deities that bless you, the angels, the UFO people, visible, invisible, all the animals, wild animals, even the flies that eat your honey. It bless you 0.5%. Fly and the bee, 1%, remember?
Yes.
If you want to go near wild animals, don't try to go near the, like, tiger or lion or something, huh? Or you? They do bless you. 2% tiger, 1% lion. I don't know why the difference. I don't know why tiger bless more. They both are predators, no? Yeah, but you can see the more flesh-eating animals, the less blessing, eh?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Elephant bless you more, eh, for example. And even birds, a small bird like my parrot, 8%. And the tiger, lion, only 1%, 2%, because they eat meat. They kill, see? Not that they wanted to, they're just born to do that. But if all animals, all people eat vegetarian, then all these tiger, lion also turn into vegetarian. They have vegetarian system in them also. It's scientifically found that they also have this dormant vegetarian, intestine, something like that in them. They can turn it, you see, anytime. Isn't that a wonderful thing that that we don't know much about anything? So everything is a wonder to us. This universe is a wonder, yes. Okay. So we are on this planet, we treasure this planet, we try to save it because we love the trees, we love the earth, we love the animals, yeah? And we love the humans on it, okay? Not because we are attached to this beautiful planet, but because we are grateful. So this planet has nourished us, loved in us so far, and everything has blessed us and loved us so much. So we love back and we want to protect it, that's all right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, thank you so much. No more questions, love? You can ask if you want. Don't be shy. But if you don't, then we meditate.
Can I ask? And, just
sure, any question. Go ahead. Go ahead.
I'm fascinated by Bob Dean.
Yes.
Who's talking about the UFOs.
Yes.
And I just wondered, are there a lot of beings here with us right now from other planets?
You don't see anything?
I see Tom here, but he kind of looks like he belongs
maybe that guy is sometimes they make themselves invisible and you don't see them, but we certainly have a lot of angels and deities hanging around. Yeah, especially when we gather like this, they also like to see us. Okay, bless us, also happy with us. They like it like this. They like this peaceful atmosphere. Attract them more than war atmosphere. You have a nice meditation hall here.
Dạ, thưa sư phụ, con rất mừng gặp sư phụ hôm nay. Thưa sư phụ, cho con hỏi là trong năm cái giới luật á, là mỗi giới luật là có năm vị thiên thần để mà chăm sóc. Mà nếu có một giới luật nào mà người đó vô tình mà bị phạm cái giới luật đó, thì cái vị thiên thần đó có biến mất hay là...
Biến mất.
Dạ, biến mất.
Không được phép bảo hộ người đó.
Dạ, cảm ơn sư phụ.
How about we all earn, 30,000 extra points here by giving Master a round of applause?
You know she's joking, right?
We're just wanting to show gratitude.
Yeah, okay. Just a joke.
Master, I have a beautiful experience from few of us.
Yes.
From today. By the booth, we have this group of people every day going by. We have this personal from Cancun I got very excited about it. The case is that this university invite us for 2 days in a row to teach students, academic, and faculty. We started today. It was so successful. Now we're going tomorrow, and they want to invite more students.
To do what?
To teach them how to cook vegetarian food.
Oh, that's nice. In Cancun?
Yes.
You live here?
We did today.
You live here? Or just for now?
No, Master. Okay. Just came.
All right. Good. 2-3 days enough. And give them this book,
We did.
And tell them Supreme Master TV more? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Good. Bravo. Wonderful. It's helpful, the booth.
Yeah. Yeah, very good.
Okay. Well, so even if I come here, you come here, we didn't help much. We could not do much with the decision that they make, but at least we help many other people. Wherever I go, people say, I start to go vegetarian today.
Yeah.
If I talk to them, they just say, yes, I will do that. Yeah, because it's logical to them.
Yes.
That's wonderful.
The Mexican people are just exceptional. The booth was, many people said immediately, they got it.
Yes.
All you had to do is say, be vegan, and they go, yes. Okay.
Very.
It was the most amazing. I was in tears actually with these beautiful people.
Yes, I went to a hotel to buy some extra clothes, the Mexican clothes, to be like a Mexican when I go meeting. And the woman tell me, I'm vegetarian already 1 month. And today I went. Interview with the television, and the girl who interviewed me said, oh, from today, I'm going vegetarian, just like that. And many people I met, after they read the book, they want signature, I say, you're going to be veg? Yeah, ma'am, yes, ma'am, wow. Sign, please. Wow. Very cute, good people here, good people. Oh, we have to give the personnel in the master or wherever you can give them also, eh? Not just the guests, if we have, okay? After you go, if any leftover books, you leave in the hotels, okay? People pick it up later on, or you bring it with you to the airport and give it to people at the airport. If it's allowed, I don't know. Or leave it in a hotel, people pick it up. Or leave in wherever it's allowed to live, all right? I tend to print more and more, but it looked like not enough. Today, how many thousand? Yesterday, were like 4,000 gone quick. Today, how many?
Today, books. We sent 1,200 books to the Cancun Mess.
To the Mess, yeah.
To the delegates.
Okay.
And flyers we give, I don't know. We printed, I think, 28,000 copies, but we finished today.
Wow. Good job.
Our initiate went out downtown. They just couldn't rest. Everybody wants.
Yes, queue up.
And,
yeah.
Oh, it's amazing, yeah.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
We could stay here forever and print books. And
yeah, I think so. I thought if we tour around Mexico, we could turn everybody into vegetarian.
Yeah, why not?
Everybody want it.
Yeah.
And
maybe we just do that, one country at a time.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have about maybe around 300 countries in the world, right? Some are very small. One day take care, the whole thing gone, right?
Oh, actually, we counted how many we gave, you know, so far. And then today, some visit the school, university, and then we couldn't count. They were so fast.
Wow.
It's just a whole bunch.
Yeah, it's very good.
They just give out one day.
Very good to give the university student because young people are easily to understand. They're open.
Yeah, and then I read your new book, From Crisis to Peace.
Mm.
I think if everybody read this book, they will turn, you know, change their heart.
Then go home and print the book and give it to people.
Especially, I thought, especially if people who are in a leader position, you know, they should read all this book, I think.
Master, we interviewed Alvarez Harrison yesterday.
Yeah.
And gave him one of your books.
Uh-huh.
And he wants you to open a vegan restaurant in Manila. He said he'd help you.
Ah, okay. Yeah, he's a nice guy.
Hmm.
He and his wife who gone vegan, gone vegetarian, yes. He's the advisor, the president about climate change.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, anything else?
I think that's it.
Okay, meditate, just meditate.
Yes, okay.
We can turn off light and meditate together.
So thank you very much for your time this evening.
It's all right.
We wish you much happiness and good health. So, thank you very much, Master.
Welcome. Please meditate now. now you're 60,000 points. Two times. All right, we meditate, huh, guys? Okay? One more thing. Be selfless all the time. Always unconditional, okay? Never want to profit from any situation for yourself. Then you get more than you expect, okay? Mm. Always selfless, always unconditional. That's the way of the working of the universe, you see? If you want the sun to bless you, then remember the sun quality. He gives all the time. He never asks anything from you. Huh? Okay? The moon, the stars, the trees, the air. Always ask nothing. That is the way we raise our consciousness. And that's how we can bless others. If we can be unconditional and selfless, okay? There's no I to give, okay? No I to take. That's the best. If you still want to take even my blessing, you are boo, low, okay? Low level. Just let it be. Naturally, what yours will come. What naturally come to you, then keep, okay? Don't try to grab anything. It's very uncomfortable for the person that you want to grab. And it's bad for you, okay? Very bad. I mean, character-wise already, Don't have to talk about spiritual blessing or level, okay? Just be natural. Be wise, be unconditional all the time. Like the sun, the moon, the sky, okay? Be big, be grand, be limitless, okay? Then you are that, all right? Don't ask me to bless you. Bless yourself. Bless yourself with all this noble quality, with the limitless power of love, all right? Don't be small. Don't be a beggar, okay? Because you will be blessed. You're blessed all the time, 24 hours, 25 hours, yes? Never worry you don't get blessing, okay? Even if you don't see the Master, you get blessed. Because the Master knows what you're doing, okay? Don't try to push. Don't try to always exhibit yourself in front of the Master so get more blessing. You're wrong. You don't get it that way. Or even if you do, very little. Compared to what you will get if you don't do that. You see, if you just do your job. We are all here for one purpose, right? To help the world and to do our job together. But if you just try to get something for yourself, then it's just out of our group already. See, out of our principle. For example, if you are assigned to do something, then just do that. We are noble, we are God. We don't do this stuff. Get me? Yeah, not because I'm strict, but I want you to be the God that you are. I don't want you to be this kind of petty thief or beggar, even for spiritual blessing. You are blessed in any way, especially when you don't grab it. See what I mean? Told you, you're blessed all the time, by remote control, by the sun, by everything. Even if you're not blessed, so what? You have Kuan Yin method already. You bless yourself, huh? Okay? We are one. We are one. We don't beg anything. Got it? You are one. You are me. What mine is yours. I told you already. You know what to expect, okay? And you know me very well. I don't want the un-God. I expect you to be the perfection. Because I know you are the perfection. I only want God around me. God, female God, male God, gay, lesbian God, big God, small God, fat God, skinny God. I don't care. Have to be God, okay? I love all type of God, but must be God. All right. We have to work together. You drive, right? Four wheels. I always say this. Four wheels have to drive together in the same direction, eh? If one wheel wants to drive in the south and the other three have to go north, you think it will do?
No.
No. We have to be like one system, okay? One. You have to do your job, I do my job, okay? When we have time, we're together like this. It's excellent, huh? Work is different, okay? When we work, we have to do the job. And then we will have reward after, okay? Or not reward, who cares? All right? You have to wake up, okay? It's not the time to play baby anymore. We have to grow up now, be man, woman, be the protectors of the planet, and work together with me, okay? Not work for me, yes? Not work because of me. Not work because want to see me, bless for me. No, no, none of all that rubbish. Got it? Okay. We are born with blessing power already. No need to ask anything more, okay? Just meditate, do your noble job. That's the big blessing to yourself. Because that means you've grown up, yeah? Mean you're noble, you are saint. You don't ask any reward. How big a saint can it be? I mean, how big a saint compared to that? How can any saint be bigger than that? You understand me? Then you congratulate yourself. Yeah? And I will love you forever. And whenever I see you, I say, come here, please. come see me. See what I mean? Yeah, I do that. No? If you work for others unconditionally, I love you so much. Believe that. Even if I don't see you, I love you. And you will feel it. Right? If you want to grab me and try to use any job or position just to get my attention or nose into my stuff or try to eat me alive, you get nothing. Yeah? Capisce? Huh? Pierre? God. Okay, now turn off the light. We meditate, all right? Thanks to all the blessing that you have. Huh? Hmm. Love you guys. Every day is different, you know? Every day is different. Very difficult. Inside. And the dogs want me home, and you want me here, and the American want me there, and the Taiwan want me there. And, you know? Yeah, everybody. And I'm just like, torn in different direction. It's not that easy. Yeah, in Mexico it's very good. Around this area it's good. It's more positive. Good for promoting a vegan lifestyle. Yeah. Because also mostly the Mexican people, they study the Maya's history and the calendar and all that. They do believe something is happening. See what I mean? Yeah. So they're more opened, yes, yes, more accepting, yeah. Because Mexico has a deep, long history, you see? So all the Mexican people know about their history, and the Maya, and the calendar of the Maya, and the prediction of the Maya. Yes. Just now I talked to two of the neighbors, you know, my neighbors, invited them, vegetarian food, I had to eat with them. And they ate, and then we talk, and then they say, the wife has been vegetarian 16 years ago, and then she stopped. It's a very amazing story. And now she said, I'm going to change from today, vegetarian again. She said, after she stopped being vegetarian, everything different lifestyle. She got sick and all that. So I said, see, it's better you change, especially now for the planet, etc., etc. And then she said, okay, after eating, talking, she said, from today, I change. She changed, you know, to vegan again. She said, she even know how to make tofu and all that. Yeah. Seitan, she knows how. I said, wow, you see that? And then she says she will be vegan from today. And the husband said, do I? He also, too. It's an amazing story. And then they told me about the Maya calendar and everything. They give me a book. And I also give them books, né? And sign and all that. It's an amazing story because they say they want to buy a piece of land in the jungle nearby here and then build a house, ecological house, with the solar power and all that stuff. I said, wow, beautiful, I'm going to build one house next to you. If I can, eh? If I can. Eh? If it's allowed, I don't know yet. Every day is different things. Today I want to stay in Mexico, tomorrow I want to go. I don't know what's going on anymore. It's not me. It's not me, you know? You are just pulling me apart in different direction. It's a very difficult time for me. Okay, I stay as much as I can. It's an amazing story. She say her daughter, she has a daughter. The daughter eat vegetarian. She decided all by herself when she was 8 years old. Their daughter. And then she continued, now she's 18, still continue vegetarian against the whole family pressure and everything. She continued vegetarian from 8 years old, decided. Continue until 18. Now she's 18. Still continue against the whole family pressure and opposition, everything. She continued. Can you believe that? 8 years old kid. Even the mother gave up, she continued. But at least because the mother had a good example. Maybe that's why she learned it from her. Yes. Of course, I give credit to the mother, huh? Yeah. And a good parents, yeah, who let her, huh? Okay. And they're very good couple, very loving couple. Yes. That's why I told you, it's a very amazing story. 8 years old kid. So strong. Hmm? I was so impressed and very touched by the story of this, you know, 10 years vegetarian against the whole family's pressure and contradiction. Huh? 8 years old kid, whole strong until 18 now, all the time, 10 years now. In a society which is not so supportive of vegetarian even, huh? You know how it's only one place in Cancun that sells vegan, huh? Okay. I was in Cancun, you know, right? Before the cop star, yeah? So praying and cleaning the atmosphere. And of course I went around looking for, because I forgot where the restaurant is. You know, it was a long time, many years before when I came here. So I forgot the restaurant go by where it was, and I looked all over. Finally we found it. But before that, I went on the safari. The taxi took me everywhere except that vegan restaurant. Everywhere, everywhere. First of all, everybody told me, that is the vegetarian restaurant that you're looking for. It was near the hotel zone. And they show me there, well, the taxi driver bring me there. He said 100% natural. 100% natural. Yeah. Everything is natural, like natural chicken, natural beef, natural pork, yeah, and a few natural lettuce and a few natural tomatoes. They say they can make anything natural for me, no problem. But I look at the menu, it's all about pork tacos, you know, chicken taquitos, beef burritos, etc. All natural. It say outside 100% natural, and the restaurant all decorated with green, you know, green plant, green names, you know, everything. The setting, it look a very natural restaurant, very beautiful, natural. Everything except salad is natural, huh? Natural chicken and natural eggs and all kind of thing. Oh my God, okay. Then we go to another place. They say, oh, this is a restaurant. I know it because I know the owner. Okay, so we went there. It says also something very, very vegetarian-like, but there's nothing there. You know, of course you can eat beans on toast. Huh? Yeah. Or tacos as is, né? Natural tacos. I mean, nothing on it. Of course you can do that, or salad, eh? Green, all green. Okay, so we left. Go to another one. I said, over there, it definitely is a vegetarian restaurant. So the taxi driver, poor taxi driver, diligently drove me there again, another restaurant. Says, super salad bowl, okay? So what can be more super than that? Super, right? Super salad bowl. So it sounds very green, huh? Eh? What can be more green than salad, right? When it's a soup and salad bowl, that means it must be vegetarian. We go there, same again. Beef tacos, yeah, chicken burritos, tuna salad. Of course you have salad on it, but they put tuna in it. Yeah, all the same. Oh, God. So we left, and then running around, similar restaurant. After that, I left for Costa Rica, you know, I went to Costa Rica. And then there is also some restaurant similar, it's all decorated with green, you know, and it says like, go green. I don't know where that comes from. I said, hey, sound familiar? And it's all green, it look all green, you know. And then we came in, oh my God, only one is vegetarian. Yeah. What was that? Vegetarian salad sandwich. Okay? They put tomatoes and cucumber in your bread. That is the only go green stuff in that restaurant. And you can have also, of course, vegetarian drink, you know? Like Cola. Yeah. Mineral water. Yeah. Okay. These are completely vegetarian. That's what they said. Oh my God. Of course, you can again have a tacos. Yeah. Nobody can stop you having a vegetarian taco there because tacos is made by corn flour. Yeah? So you can just eat that. Why not? Go green. The restaurant is called Go Green. Truly like that. I'm not kidding. Nowadays, all kind of names, you know, 100% natural, Super Bowl salad, Go Green. Another one called All Veggie, you know, thing like that, but nothing veggie except myself. The customer bring their own veggie there if you want. Oh God, in Mexico. And she hold on all this time, holds on from 8 years old already. Even when mother already quit, she continue, believe you, insisting eating vegetarian, don't want anything meat or, and not even eggs or milk, nothing. Cheese, nothing. Wow, huh? So if you think you are strong, remember the kid. So I gave her 3 of my bestseller books, signing with all love and respect. And of course the new book as well, huh? And every other things. But all the 3 books I gave to the girl, I said, with all my love and respect, in the name of God and in the name of animals, thank you. I love you so much. All my love. Yeah, she deserves it, huh? Yes. Deserves. Yeah. So it was a very amazing story. But this couple also very lovely, you know? Very loving with each other also. Lovely, lovely. And they were going to a seminar, yeah, where they learn how to build eco-friendly houses. And then they were going to buy a piece of land in the jungle because they want to build an eco house themselves. Yes, with the solar power and wind power and those stuff. Because she said this is the future now. She wants her children to integrate into the new future generation. I say, yeah, yes. Vegan now also future. We have to look into the future now, yes. And of course I told her that 51% plus are caused by animal product, etc., etc. And they convinced right away. People here are very open. If you have a chance to tell them, they change. I'm so amazed, yes. Good people, hey? Very good people. The Mexican people are very blessed, with so many spiritual blessings lying, especially in this region. Yeah. Maybe that's why people are relaxed here. Yes, even police are lovely. Yes. Okay, so today you had a good day?
Master, while calling to the media, we just tell them we want to send them Christmas gift with your book. So I called to a company which is radio and television and also newspaper. I asked them like how many books they need for everyone. And he told me everyone. And I said, yeah, we want to give a copy to everyone. No one left behind. And he said, are you sure everyone? Mm-hmm. And I said, yes, everyone, please. Everyone was telling me like 20 or 30 at most. And he told me, we are more than 400 people. So I said, oh, well, maybe just the key people then. And he told me, well, if you want to be like, to reach all the important people, just 272.
Oh, just? Okay, give it to them. Yes.
Sure, Master.
Some are bigger and some smaller, right? You mean that's just one company, right?
Yes, it's one company that has everything, all the medias. Like it has radio, and it has television, and it has newspaper.
That's why it's a lot of people. I give it to them. Yes, give it to them. We can always print more. The media needs to know because they will spread. Okay? The media deserves. All right? If they are so good like that, they deserve. Just give it to them. Okay.
Sure, Master.
one day this, 1 minute that, you know, it's a lot going on. I haven't got a time to sit down because there are other priorities I have to check first, you know? Even if you can see everything like a movies, you have to see time, you know, take time, because in this physical body, the computer take time. The computer take time, yes. So sometimes you see I'm not doing anything. I'm always doing something, huh? Checking my computer. It's just like you sit in your office and check your email and stuff. I also check my email, huh? Yes.
Master, we went to see some of the consulates today and drop off some books to them. They were very nice. And we showed them the books, even though maybe some of them couldn't read English that well, they enjoyed the pictures in the books.
Yes. The books I deliberately write very little.
Yes.
You see? So even people who don't understand much English will understand.
Yes.
Easy for them to understand and easy for somebody to translate quick, you know, like neighbors or friend translate to them. What does this sentence say? Because it's only a few sentences.
Yes.
See? So it's more international. English already international, but I wrote it concentrate and small. You see? So that it doesn't take a lot of time to translate if the person don't understand English. Okay?
And they're attracted by the pictures, like right away, even,
yes,
you
yes,
know, again,
yes.
Oh, so beautiful.
Yes, yes.
Anyway, the Belgian consulate said he wasn't able to come to the gala because they had many, many obligations.
Understand,
at
understand.
That time,
yeah,
with COVID 16.
Of course, of course.
But he knew about us, and he had seen us at the Climate Change Village,
yes.
And he said, wow, you guys have a very passionate campaign.
We're passionate.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
But he had seen us everywhere, and he was very impressed.
When we showed Master's new book, From a Crisis to Peace, he immediately opened to a page that's talking about Belgium, one of the city clean.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It was so amazing. Just open the book, and it's that page.
Yeah, and he loves.
Yeah,
he loves.
He's also surprised talking about his country. Mm-hmm. He also felt proud.
Yeah, yes, yes. That city all go vegan once a week.
Yeah,
Thursday,
yeah.
Ghent, and then that city impressed the whole world. Everybody want to learn how they do it. Even see, it's very famous. No wonder. Okay, and then after that,
yeah.
Huh? Feel at home.
Yeah, he felt proud of his country.
Ah, yes.
And we also praised their country.
Yeah, as a leader. And then after a while, he realized that we really want nothing. Just to save humans. Yes, just to save humans. And the planet. Of course the planet because of humans, yeah? Mm. Okay, very good. Good job.
Thank you.
European Parliament supports reducing meat to lower greenhouse gases.
Roll call vote. Vote is now open.
Reduce your meat consumption or stop eating meat totally.
During discussions on greenhouse gas reduction goals,
the climate
Committee
change.
Of the European Parliament officially recognized livestock's contribution to global warming and recommended a reduction of subsidies to the livestock industry to curb methane.
The European Parliament has adopted its own position on climate change as an institution. And as a vice president, one of the proposals I've made is in line with your own, which is that we should eat far less meat, because that's one of the major sources of greenhouse gases.
We know that the agriculture and the meat production is one of the main causes of gas emission. And so it's very clear that the ratio per habitant of meat has to decrease.
My name is Jens Holm. I'm a member of the European Parliament. Please, be veg. Go green to save the planet.
When we visit one press, and there was a lady from a bus company.
Yeah.
But she said they have like more than 1,000 people there.
Mm.
750 drivers, 250 mechanic, and some administration people. It's called Tricom Bus Company.
What do they do?
A
bus company.
Yeah, yeah, it's bus company.
No wonder they have so many drivers. Yeah.
Yes, and they have some kind of class, you know, every week, like take turn, you know, 50 or 60 children.
Yeah.
And she said, oh, she saw the book Birds in My Life. Oh, this is so good. I want to read to my students.
Mm.
And then I gave also Dogs in My Life, or you can read this, and I asked her, oh, if you need more, we can supply more, you know? And then she said, oh, children are so open. They can observe everything, what I read. So she was very happy to find these books, and happy.
Just for her? Not for the company?
I gave, like, about 100 flyers and some books, but we didn't have enough to give all our books, you know, all for them.
Okay.
But she was very happy to see those books.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm. Very good. And then whatever left over after the consulate and police and journalists, we can give to school, library, and okay?
El día de hoy, fuimos un equipo de iniciados al centro de la ciudad, en la plaza principal, en la entrada principal, en un lugar muy especial, y nos preguntaron cómo habíamos conseguido ese lugar totalmente gratis, que era muy, 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 muy difícil poder conseguir ese espacio. Y la persona que me lo dijo fue el dueño de una zapatería vegana, y dice, es que están haciendo un muy, muy buen trabajo.
She says like today they have a booth in a very good mall, the main mall, and in the main entrance. So the owner of a vegan shoe store, they told them, how you get this spot?
Vegan?
Vegan shoe store. Yes, master. Yes.
Oh, we have such thing in Cancun?
Yes, they live here, master.
Wow, good, good, good.
In Plaza Las Americas, where they have the booth, is where he has his shoe shop as well.
Vegan shoe shop.
Vegan shoe shop.
And then?
And then he told them, how come you get such a good spot for free? It's almost impossible. And
que solamente se podía haber conseguido del cielo.
You can only get this good spot through heaven.
Se dio mucha, mucha, mucha información porque hubo mucha gente. Y charolas de comida. Y solo dos personas estaban preparando la comida y se pudo preparar mucha, mucha, mucha comida.
It was a lot of people, and we could give them a lot of food. And it was amazing because it was only two people who were preparing the food. Only making sandwiches, two people.
Okay.
Hamburguesas, eran hamburguesas.
And hamburgers, and they were very tasty.
Vegan hamburger.
Vegan hamburger. Vegan hamburger, yes.
I don't want the future generation think, what day are he giving our hamburger? This is a problem with Jesus and Buddha already, you know? That's why everybody say Jesus eat fish and Buddha eat pork.
Yes, master.
You know what I mean? So every time you say something like pork, beef, you have to say vegan beef.
Yes, master.
Vegan pork. Vegan chicken. Okay?
Yes.
All right. But because we know they are all vegan, so we always say, oh, yeah, take some hamburger, take some chicken, take some fish. You see? But the outside people, they don't know. And if somebody hear only these sentences, they think we're eating, you know, animal stuff.
Este es el problema con la comida. Tenemos que decir antes de decir hamburguesa o antes de decir sándwich, tenemos que decir vegano. Es comida vegana. Este ya es el problema con Jesucristo y con Buda. Por eso dicen que comía pescado y que comía puerco.
Try to remember as much as you can. I also sometimes forget.
Traten de recordarlo tanto como puedan, porque a mí también se me olvida.
Vegetarianism and religion.
The Baha'i Faith,
Regarding the eating of animal flesh and abstinence therefrom, know thou of a certainty that in the beginning of creation God determined the food of every living being, and to eat contrary to that determination is not approved. Selections from the Baha'i Writings on Some Aspects of Health and Healing. Buddhism. All meats eaten by living beings are of their own relatives. Lankavatara Sutra. Also, after the birth of the baby, care must be exercised not to kill any animal in order to feed the mother with meaty delicacies, and not to assemble many relatives to drink liquor or to eat meat, because at the difficult time of birth, there are innumerable evil demons, monsters, and goblins who want to consume the smelly blood. By ignorantly and adversely resorting to the killing of animals for consumption, they bring down curses upon themselves, which are detrimental to both the mother and the baby. Kasithigarbha Sutra, Chapter 8. Be careful during the days immediately after someone's death, not killing or destroying, or creating evil karma by worshipping or offering sacrifice to demons and deities, because such killing and slaughtering committed, or such worship performed, or such sacrifice offered, would not have even an iota of force to benefit the dead, but would entwine even more sinful karma into previous karma, making it even deeper and more serious, thus delay his rebirth to a good state. Karma means retribution. Kasithigarbha Sutra, Chapter 7.
Cow die. The most important thing is to stop killing, because animals also have souls and understand like humans. If we kill and eat them, then we owe them a blood debt. Teachings of the Saints.
Christianity. Meats for the belly, and the belly for meats. But God shall destroy both it and them. Holy Bible.
And while the flesh was yet between their teeth, ere it was chewed, the wrath of the Lord was kindled against the people, and the Lord smote the people with a very great plague. Holy Bible.
Confucianism. All men have a mind which cannot bear to see the sufferings of others. The superior man, having seen the animals alive, cannot bear to see them die. Having heard their dying cries, he cannot bear to eat their flesh. Mencius. Essenes. I am come to end the sacrifices and feasts of blood, and if ye cease not offering and eating of flesh and blood, the wrath of God shall not cease from you. Gospel of the Holy Twelve.
Hinduism.
Since you cannot bring killed animals back to life, you are responsible for killing them. Therefore, you are going to hell. There is no way for your deliverance. Adilila.
He who desires to augment his own flesh by eating the flesh of other creatures lives in misery in whatever species he may take his birth. Mahabharata Anu.
Islam. Allah will not give mercy to anyone except those who give mercy to other creatures. Hadith.
Do not allow your stomachs to become graveyards of animals. Hadith.
Jainism. A true monk should not accept such food and drink as has been specially prepared for him involving the slaughter of living beings. Sutrakatanga.
Judaism. And whatsoever man there be of the house of Israel, or of the strangers that sojourn among you, that eateth any manner of blood, I will even set my face against that soul that eateth blood, and will cut him off from among his people. Holy Bible. Blood, meaning flesh.
Sikhism. Those mortals who consume marijuana, flesh, and wine, no matter what pilgrimages, fasts, and rituals they follow, they will all go to hell. Guru Granth Sahib.
Taoism. Do not go into the mountain to catch birds and nets, nor to the water to poison fishes and minnows. Do not butcher the ox that plows your field. Tract of the Quiet Way.
Tibetan Buddhism. The offering to the deities of meat obtained by killing animate beings is like offering a mother the flesh of her own child, and this is a grievous failure, the supreme path of discipleship.
Zoroastrianism. Those plants, I, Ahura Mazda, or God, rain down upon the earth to bring food to the faithful and fodder to the beneficent cow, Avesta.
Everybody knows that vegetarian diet is good for health and to save the planet. They will be awakening their own great, compassionate, loving self-nature, and then their level of consciousness will rise up automatically, and they will understand more than they ever did, and they'll be closer to heaven than what they are right now.
Nosotros ahorita en ese lugar estamos regalando los libros
de los perros de mi vida, de los pájaros y de los animales silvestres. Y les pedimos a las personas que para ganárselo necesitaban hacer un poema o una reflexión sobre el calentamiento global o sobre las ventajas de ser vegetariano. Y obtuvimos poemas y reflexiones sumamente bellas. Ahorita las traigo y quedamos de regalarles el libro a las 15, 20, 25 personas. O sea, las que más podamos regalarles el libro el día de mañana para que se les premiara de esa forma. Y obtuvimos cosas bien bellas en el material que traemos.
In the book, we are also giving the birds in my life, the dogs in my life, and the noble wilds book. So in order to get these books, we asked them for a thought or for a poem or poetry, something on climate change or veganism. So we really got very beautiful stuff, so we can give a reward for these 15 people or maybe 20 people with the most beautiful thoughts.
Oh, well, that's good. Okay. Mm. That's very good.
Eso es muy bueno.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's late. Are you guys tired or not? You okay? Work all day and now sitting here. Okay. Very good.
Hoy cuando llamé para contactar a una reportera, ella trabaja en una agencia de información. Cuando le pregunté cuántas personas eran, me dijo que eran dos, pero que ella daba clases en la universidad donde se dieron las clases veganas.
Today we contact a journalist, and when I asked her how many people in her office were, she said only two. But I work in a university, in the technological university, where we gave the vegan cooking class.
Y me preguntó que si también a ellos les podíamos llevar libros, que eran 100 personas.
And she asked me like if we can give them book as well for them, that they were 100 people.
Son 100 maestros.
There are 100 teachers.
Teachers can also give, yes. At least a peace book.
Huh? A los maestros sí les puedes dar, aunque sea el libro de la paz.
Yes. And one set, okay? Peace book maybe 100, but one set of the four.
Y un juego, quizás cuatro juegos nada más, y 100 libros del libro de la paz.
One or two so they can put in their library and they read together.
Uno o dos juegos de modo que lo puedan poner en su biblioteca y leerlo juntos.
Depends on how many we have. Yeah.
Depende de cuántos tengamos.
Okay.
Good. Okay. Gracias.
Yes. A peace book is important. Everybody should have one.
Sí. Hoy fue una jovencita muy emocionada porque desde la villa se volvió vegana y dice que se siente muy muy contenta, muy sana. Y está muy interesada en saber más de nosotros, de usted.
Today in the booth we also receive a visit for a young lady who became vegan since she met us in Climate Village.
Oh.
She said she feels very healthy, very good.
Yes.
So she's eager to know more about you and to learn more about you.
Oh, learn more about vegan and peace.
Que aprenda más del veganismo y de la paz.
It's good. It's good that you have convinced at least one person that we know. I'm sure more, huh? I'm sure more have been convinced, right? From the village.
Es bueno que hayan convencido por lo menos una persona, pero estoy segura que más de una persona se convenció en la villa.
Up to now, whomever I meet and talk to, promise vegan. Mm.
Ahora cada vez que le hago a alguien promete ser vegano.
People are very open here. Hey, good job anyway, well done. Mm-hmm. You've been working well. I'm proud of you.
Master, I just wanted to tell you that you look really beautiful today.
Oh, really?
Yeah, your clothes and your face and your eyes, very shiny.
Thank you
beautiful.
Very much. Thanks a lot. Continue to do until you have to go home, eh? Oh, I supposed to go today also. I changed the etiquette many times. I keep changing. Yeah, really, really. I supposed to go already today. I mean, I supposed to go many days already, and then many days already, and many days already, and supposed to go today, and then I changed my etiquette. Okay, let's see how many more days. Every day is different information. Yeah, every day is the karma of the people change so fast. Sometimes I'm also dizzy. I'm dizzy, you know. Because we live together, you see, on this planet. We are all influenced by each other's behavior or karma or thinking. Yeah, that is a problem. Mm. All right, so nothing is really definite, huh, all the time. I come see you every day, almost every day, or whenever I can. Yeah. Cancun is very, very blessed. Everywhere I go, I bump into spiritual blessing line, I'm telling you. Cancun alone, you know, Cancun is like the small area, yeah? But here even, huh? Incredible. It's really incredible. Yeah. Cancun has three, huh? But other areas also have, huh? Yes, it's very good areas. It's this very blessed area here. Maybe that's why people build houses, big hotels, and everybody come here for holidays, because they're happy, happy, huh? Otherwise, we have beaches everywhere, right? Not just Cancun. Almost the whole Mexico is like a peninsula, and it's surrounded by beaches. But people came to Cancun a lot, yeah. Yeah.
You mentioned about the heaven light.
Yeah.
Yeah, like in Haiti, you said it's a blessing heaven light to bless us and protect us.
Mm-hmm.
What are different all of those lights? And like when we get initiated, you get the light.
Mm-hmm.
And what the and the SBL light?
Oh, this is different. It's different.
Are they from the same place or?
No, I told you already, it's from the fifth level, no? Spiritual blessing line, no? Is to keep the planet in peace, no? Yeah. Keep it in balance. No? Mm. Other stars and planets, they also have spiritual blessing lines to keep them in balance. Yes. The more the better. No? The initiation is your own light, no? Heaven light. No? Everybody has the spiritual blessing line, also same. No? It's just for to bless the planet, yeah? And your light is yours. And the light from heaven is to protect you double, yeah? More extra support, okay? When you're doing some hard work or dangerous job, yeah? Okay?
Okay. Thank you, Master.
Yeah. Of course, you have light inside you already. At the time of initiation is awakened, your light open again, yeah? Connected again. But extra light from heaven sometimes, because there's a gathering of bodhisattva, saints, invisible one, or angels over there as well. You see what I mean? So you see those lights are from them. Got it? Yeah. And spiritual blessing lines are pure essence of blessing, to bless the whole planet. Okay? We have many crisscrossing all over, like a ball with the knitting around it, yes, so that it will keep the planets in balance, in peace. But we have destroyed too many, yes. Now there are some left over, trying to fix it, to strengthen, yes, to strengthen and to lengthen, or to complete it, those, whatever possible, whenever possible, so that we can keep the planet for a little longer. And the human change into more compassionate, natural lifestyle. Because human's nature should be loving and kind. See what I mean? We have not all been loving and kind. And we broke many spiritual blessing line or destroy. And if we continue like this, then we'll be none left. Yeah? Yeah. I'm just trying to fix some. Okay? Yeah. So that we have some. Just like your clothes are torn, but I'm mending it. Okay, mending it, yes. Better than broken, huh? If we don't have new clothes, at least our clothes are fixed and mend, yeah? So you can cover your body, huh? From the elements, from cold and wind and rain, huh? Okay. Everybody happy? Good. Continue to work, okay? Yes. When you meditate here, I really would like you to meditate more than work, but please distribute all the book quick, and then you meditate, okay? Here you meditate from 10 to 3, you get, wow, like 3 billion points. Wow. 1 hour. I stay as long as I can, huh? Profit it, okay? Yes. That's why I really keep asking, where is everybody? You know? I'm sorry that you had to work. Okay, never mind, keep working. And if we have to, we stay longer. Huh? Mm. Yeah. I'm thinking what is best for you, you know? Even though it's far from the beach, I care about the SBL. Okay, okay, I'm good. You take turn to come, have a holiday as well, and meditate. Over there, and here, or here, you know. If you meditate there, you get 4 billions an hour, huh? Billion, not million. Yeah. During the peak time, huh? Peak time. And other time, half of it. Yeah? Normal time, half of it. Hmm? Holiday. Spiritual holiday. Take a bath in the spiritual blessing. Yeah. All right, I'm going now. You go sleep and continue meditate or sleep, okay? And whenever you can, any time in the day, whenever you can, meditate, huh? Mm. Even if thinking of meditation, recite the names, think of God, is also have good effect, okay? Yes, doesn't have to be like sit cross-legged, but of course when you sit still, you conserve the energy better, yeah, you conserve the blessing better. Just like if I shower in you, but you run around and you don't get that wet, that quick. But if you stand still, you know, then you shower quicker and get wet quicker. Understand? That's why we meditate. Yes? Sometimes you run around, you don't think very, very clearly, but as soon as you sit down, the idea come quick. Right?
Yes.
Or sometimes you sit in the sun, it's even better. You're clear, you're more clear. Huh? Mm. And if you eat more simple, then your body is more clear. Less burden, okay? Less burden. Your clear thinking, yeah? It's simple and less, huh? Okay? It doesn't mean go hungry or anything, just the simple, the better, okay? Yeah, all right. Okay, see you, huh? Thank you for working today, sacrificing, yes. You can meditate more, eh? In the good hours, yes? And if you continue to work, it's okay, but at least save some time in meditation. Now you know how precious it is. Even if you just sit there and you don't concentrate very well, in the spiritual blessing line and in the sun, you still get more. You understand me? You still get the point. Yes? Try to do more Kuan Yin, okay, huh?
Okay.
I know it's easier just to sit like this, but Kuan Yin is also important for you. All right? Okay. Remember sun, air, forest, trees, flowers, plants. That's why we're trying to avoid eating the plants. You see what I mean? Now that you know everything. We eat fruit, yeah? Yeah, and eat simple, okay? Mm. Fruit is a lot already, you know, like beans also, type of fruit, yeah? Yeah. A cucumber also fruit, tomatoes fruit, yeah? That's already a lot of things to eat. There's no need to even a vegetable, you know? Not to talk about animals. See what I mean? So it's a pity that the planetary people are not awakened to that, not so much informed and convinced about that. But whoever we talk to here, they're convinced and they try to change, huh? Yeah, for me at least. Yeah, I'm very happy about that. Just now I talked to the neighbors, to the Mexican couple, and immediately they said, from today, two vegetarian. Wow. Yes. I told you. Just told you. And I just met them two times. The first time when I first came and just said, hello, you live up there, I live here. And they immediately say, if I need something, I can always come up and ask them. I say, yeah, the same here. And then that's it. And then today I came back and I saw them come in and they say, hello. I say, hello. And they say, oh, please come in and have a drink, you know, a juice or something. They just came in because they like me only, you know, they did not really need. They had dinner already, but then I invite them vegetarian food. Also, they eat, you know, graciously, say tasty and all that. And then after we talk, you know, for a while, that's it. Vegan from today. Mm. Cool, eh? Okay, be good, huh? Mm. You're very lucky. You know everything. Spiritual blessing, sunshine blessing, wind blessing, tree blessing, and sun blessing. Every day, thank everything, okay? Because even if you don't thank them, they also don't care. But the more grateful you are, the more you get. You know why? Not because they give less, just because you're grateful. And then your attitude change. You're humble, you see, and your vibration changes. You go to a higher level. And the higher you go, the more blessing you can absorb. That's it. Oh, you understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So gratefulness doesn't mean that the animals or the trees or the sun or the deities really need you to say thank you in order to give more. It's not like that. They don't care. They give without condition. Yeah, even animals, trees, plants, they give their permission. But the more grateful we are, the more they're in tune with all that surrounds us and blessing us. Yeah, because we're humble. Yeah, humble means no ego. Huh? No ego means divinity shine, more divine. Yeah, the divine within you, higher, you see, more percentage than the ego. So you're more connected with goodness. You see, with divinity, with blessing, and you get more blessing. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Thank you. Wow. Yes. Okay. Very good. I'm very happy that you came. Good for you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good for you. All right. Yeah, you have a lot more points to take home, huh? Yeah. I don't know if your country has, I have to go there and check, you know what I mean? So right now I'm here and I told you the places. Yeah? Very good places. Okay?
Can I ask that?
Yeah. How many people you cook for today? How did you do that? Sandwich about this big, you know, two slices.
Yeah, two slices.
Ah, okay. Good kids. Okay. Good for you also. Good for the people. My God, you try so hard. And people, if people don't turn, then there's nothing else you can do. Okay? You do what you can. Okay? After the period, if it's, heaven don't want us to help anymore, then we also have to stop. Thank you.
Some of the diseases related to meat consumption and or production. Fatal prion diseases transmissible through air or milk. Rabies, anthrax, sleeping sickness, Q fever, norovirus, swine flu, Ebola Reston virus. Cured meats and fish increase leukemia risk in children. Antibiotic-resistant superbug infections from a strain of Staphylococcus aureus. Blue tongue disease, E. coli, Salmonella, bird flu, mad cow disease, or Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, 90% of the population at risk. Pig's disease, or PMWS, listeriosis, shellfish poisoning, preeclampsia, Campylobacter, Clostridium difficile, diseases hidden in healthy appearing livestock.
Some of the costs of meat eating.
Infertility. Eating just one serving of meat per day increases the risk of women's infertility by 32%, with additional meat consumption increasing the risk.
Heart disease. Over 17 million lives lost globally each year. Cost of cardiovascular disease is at least $1 trillion US a year.
Cancer. Increased childhood cancers and adult reproductive cancers from hormones in meat.
Colon rectal cancer. Over 1 million new colon cancer patients diagnosed each year. More than 600,000 colon cancer related mortalities annually. In the United States alone, colon cancer treatment costs about $6.5 billion US. Millions of people are newly diagnosed with other meat-related cancers every year.
Diabetes. 246 million people are affected worldwide.
An estimated $174 billion US spent each year on treatment in just the United States. Obesity. Worldwide, 1.6 billion adults are overweight, with 400 million more who are obese. Costs $93 billion US each year for medical expenses in the United States alone. At least 2.6 million people die annually from problems related to being overweight or obese.
Environmental. Use up to 70% of clean water. Pollute most of the water bodies. Deforest the lungs of the earth. Uses up to 43% of the world's cereal. Uses up to 85% of the world's soy. Cause world hunger and wars. 80% cause of global warming. Plus more.
Some of the costs of milk consumption. Cowpox from milking cows. Bacterial microbes, pesticides, and enzymes found in cheese derived from the inner stomach linings of other animals. Up to 80% of the calories in cheese are from pure fat. Breast, prostate, and testicular cancer from hormones present in milk. Listeria and Crohn's disease. Hormones in saturated fat leads to osteoporosis, obesity, diabetes, and heart disease. Linked to higher incidences of multiple sclerosis. Classified as a major allergen. Lactose intolerance. Plus more.
For help quitting, please visit
For more urgent information, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/killers.
I can save the souls, you know? If I have more time to meditate, I can save all the souls on the planet. Even if I have more. Right now, I can save like 2/3 already. Wow. Just have to continue to meditate for the longer, more important is I meditate and you meditate. Yes, yes, you save the soul, you cannot save the material world, you save the souls so that they can go to a better world, better planet. All right, understand that? Yes, yes. So yeah, do this 4 days and then meditate before you go home, meditate as much as you can here. I don't know where you go have the spiritual blessing lying for. You have too many different places. I have to be there in order to see. Okay? Sometimes I can see from afar, but sometimes not. Okay? Yes. It's a more complicated than you think. Okay? Yes. But if I'm in a place, then I know for sure that there's no escape. Okay? So every day you come back, you maintain with me.
Yeah.